So I've just had the opportunity to see the Port Side, the world premiere showing of the Port Side. And one of the things that was very interesting to me was to see the pictures of the photographs of the various places that existed in Vancouver where gays, lesbians, trans, bisexual people were able to gather, and how all the ones that they showed, I think, no longer exist. And so the one that means something to me is the Gandhi Dancer, which I remember going to in 1990, which I didn't realize at the time, but that was the last year that the Gandhi Dancer was functioning. And it was my very first time going out as a lesbian to a lesbian bar, event, dance. And it has a very important place in my own kind of coming out, because I had only returned to Canada in 1989 and was only beginning my own coming out process in a very public kind of way at that point. Many people know that I used to be a Roman Catholic nun, and so that having come out in very publicly in 1989 and then going to the Gandhi Dancer was like a huge big step for me. So I really that really resonated when I saw the Gandhi Dancer showing there. And I remember going there, and it was somewhere down around where the roundhouse is now. It was like it was all warehouses and buildings of bricks, and it was very weird at night going into this place, even though it was only not quite 20 years ago, and yet it still had that feeling of being part of a subculture because of where it was and how we had to get there, and what the building was like, you know, with the old bricks and the warehouse kind of style. So it's interesting that it's gone now, and that was really only 20 years ago, or a little less than 20 years ago in Vancouver. And it's kind of sad to me how many spaces that have existed over time that we've actually lost and no longer have those spaces, because we don't have anywhere near as many spaces as we used to. So it's kind of sad, and yet at the same time, I know there's lots more opportunities for us. And I remember going to the Gay Games when they came to Vancouver in 1990, and all of that sort of excitement that there was around that era. And I think it was kind of I have a sense that it was part of a big movement that has brought us to more or less where we are today.